I've been a police officer up in Jersey City for 13 years. I'm always jumping over cars, climbing over fences, jumping from roof to roof, chasing people. So this game to me should be easy. Knock on wood.
What is it you like about being part of the Brawn tribe?
Well, we're gonna stomp on beauty and we're gonna stomp on the smarts.
I've been a cop for quite a while, and there is a look that cops have, and Tony's got it.
If I'm wrong, he should go be a cop because he looks just like one.
Will you look at me real quick? Will you be honest with me?
Uh-huh.
Are you a cop?
No way.
You swear?
I swear.
You look like a cop.
I could be a cop if you want. Why?
You swear you're not?
I swear. Why? I wouldn't hide that.
What do you do?
Construction. Tiles.
Yeah?
That's my main thing, but I do roofing too. Jersey City.
You look like a cop. You look like...
I have a tattoo here. They don't allow that.
How do you know?
I have plenty of cop friends. You don't know no cops?
No, I do know cops.
I have like maybe 50 friends that are cops. I thought for a split second, should I tell them I'm a cop? Then I said, nah, you know what? If I tell them I'm a police officer, the first thing they're going to be thinking is like, this guy's strategical, he's tactical, he's probably sharp on his toes, he's very observant, and they're going to be right. So obviously I'm a threat to them, so they're going to probably want to try to blindside me right away.
I'm a cop.
Are you really a cop? You're a pretty cool girl, Sarah. You know what? I got a confession to make. Want me to tell you the truth?
Yeah.
I'm not a cop.
You're lying to me.
I'm not.
You are.
I thought you were going to say, I'm awake. No, get out of here.
Yeah.
Trish and I, we're walking on eggshells with these people. And that's when I came up with the idea, like, try to spy on them. So as I'm building the shelter, I'm trying to act like I'm trying to protect them from the rain and everything, but I'm building a spy shack. I'm trying to cover up a little cubby hole in the corner. And I'm going to run around the beach and crawl up to here. And I'm going to be right here listening to what they got to say. And I'm going to hear everything. So whatever useless Cliff tells Weasel Woo, I'm gonna know crucial information. That's the key to this. It's not just small talk. It's gonna be big talk. That's what I'm looking for. I have more brain than brawn. Little do they know. The first thing that popped in my mind, there has to be some kind of idol or a clue to an idol in that basket. I opened up, it's a little wooden tackle box, and I see a little piece of paper in there. So when I went back into the basket, I took it out and I put it in my pocket. And this is what it looks like. This is what it looks like. This is what it looks like. I went right into the lake and finally I felt a lump, and sure enough, it was an idol right there and I found it. This is huge. I needed this. Ooh, I'm king of the jungle. King of the jungle. King of the jungle. Words.
You swear on your badge you won't turn your back on me.
Oh, I swear on everything I love. I won't turn my back on you, whatever. She had me swear on my badge, which that doesn't mean anything to me, swearing on my badge. Because I'm here to lie, cheat, and steal. I'm here to drag people's dreams through the mud so I can fulfill mine. That's what I'm here for. Whatever I have to do, I'm going to do. It's as simple as that.
Anna wins immunity.
Where do idols come into play? Do you think they have been found? Do you think somebody has one?
The fact that no idol has appeared, this could be some big survivor joke. I'm not sure.
Meaning there aren't any.
There's idols, because I got one. And I'm going to use it for my tribe.
You have an idol?
Of course I do.
Yeah, you want to pull it out?
What's that going to prove?
That you are telling the truth.
And what's that going to get me? Where's that going to get me?
Well, you just told us that you have one, so.
All right. This right here. Inquiring minds want to know. Inquiring eyes want to see. It's right here. All right? And I'm going to wear it with pride.
If anybody has a hidden immunity idol and you want to play it, now would be the time to do so.
Can you check to see if this is valid for me? Can you validate it for me, please, Jeff?
Yes, this is a hidden immunity idol.
I would like to give it to LJ.
Seventh person voted out, the first member of our jury. Sarah.
Hi, Wayne.
Bang, bang.
Cass, zero chance of winning the game.
It's a long way to go.
You know it's bad when Morgan, the girl that you can't tell if she's a pillow or a person because she doesn't do anything, you know it's serious when she's up on her ass and she's looking for this idol. Right now, my red flag's raised because I blindsided LJ. I'm in trouble, so I'm gonna have to do something to get myself out of it. Most people, including myself, we go all the way to the water well because it's a bit further away from camp where people can't hear you, and that's where they talk strategy. So I started working on some blueprints to make a nice little shack around the water well. The water well is here. There's a tree there, and I put some bushes and some shrubs and some broken branches where I can hide right in that, and I'm within 5 feet away. That's where I'll be the most patient when I'm sitting in my spy shack.
I'm sorry, but I don't want to be fooled by Tony, because I feel like, honestly, he's playing us, Trish.
Definitely think that Tony went into the wrong business. I think he's an Academy Award-winning actor.
I know, but we gotta be careful with that.
While I was doing my surveillance, I did hear Jeffrey and Trish talking, and Trish said that Tony's gonna win an Academy Award for his acting skills.
I'm okay with blindsiding LJ and getting him out or whatever, but it's the way that he went about it that makes me not want to trust Tony.
I trust Trish, I trust Ruth, I trust Cass. That's pretty much it. I don't really trust Jeffrey anymore because she doesn't trust me. And if she doesn't trust me, I'm not gonna trust her. So now I'm in trouble. So I start digging, I start scratching. And then I felt something. So I took a piece of stick and I start digging. Something's got it. And I said, oh, please, please let this be it. Oh my God. I almost passed out. I was just so happy. And then when I opened it, it's the special idol. Oh. Oh my God. Wow. I love you so much, man. This special idol that I found today is priceless.
This hidden immunity idol will keep you safe from being voted out at tribal council. Unlike other hidden immunity idols, this idol can be played after the votes are read.
After you see the votes, you can use it. Everybody's eyes say, bing!
This immunity idol only protects the person who finds it. You may not give this immunity idol to another tribe member. I'm hiding right now, and I gotta go wash up.
You know how powerful that is? Oh, I'm gonna show you how powerful that is. And here it is. I've been looking for this for so long now. Come to Papa. I love you so much. That's what I've been looking for. That's the third idol that I found this game. Right now, I currently have two idols in my possession. One special one and one idol I could just play around with. I can use it for me. I can give it to somebody to blind somebody else. I feel like I'm on top of the world, on top of this game. What, are you gonna vote me out?
I think I will write your name down.
You know what's gonna happen? You're gonna go home.
That's fine.
Okay. As long as we clear the air.
Yeah, make sure you play your idol.
Listen, don't tell me how to play. You write my name down, you're going home.
Play your idol.
Write my name down.
I will, Tony.
And you'll go home.
Because you're running the show?
And you'll go home. No, because I got a special idol, that's why. That's why.
I'm sure you do.
You guys hear that? Spence, you heard what I told her?
Yes, no, you're the special idol.
And you'll go home. Put my name down.
So show it to us.
I don't have to. Put my name down and you'll see it.
I'm going to.
You'll be the first to see it.
I'm going to. No, I just want to get rid of one guy.
You can't. You can't.
Right there.
You can't.
Yeah, I can?
Yes, you can't.
Okay. We'll see.
We will see.
We'll see what happens.
Okay, there you go. You're done.
Would you like a napkin there? Mm-hmm. Oh my God, Tony, you're gonna throw up. Stop. Mm. I know you're hungry, but it's not worth it to eat it and then have it all come back up on you.
I've never seen anyone snort a pizza down like Tony. I saw it coming out of his nose and his ears, and there was sauce and there was pineapples flying everywhere. I was like, whoa, dude, slow down.
Empty box. How do you? I'm sorry, I don't talk llama. I'm supposed to talk llama to you. You understand that better?
Young lady here is delusional. This is what happened. Wu approaches me and says, hey, Tony, Cass is talking to Spencer. They want to blindside you. So I go up to Cass and say, Cass, let's just be cool. We can make it to the end, but it's between us, blah, 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 blah. She goes back to camp.
Hey, Wu, is it true that you told Tony this and that and this and that?
I said, Cass, what is wrong with you? You just sealed your own fate. Why would you go tell him what I just told you if we're working together?
Well, actually, the Wu exchange worked out exactly how I thought it would because
she's a strategist, Jeff, that she planned this all along.
I was like, please, I was looking for my wife, and I didn't see my wife, man.
Man, you look like a different man, see?
I seen my best friend Arnold, and it sucked because I was anticipating my wife, you know, I was looking forward to seeing my wife, but I just don't think she could leave a four-month-old baby home to come out here. I mean, it was hard enough for me to do it, but I know it was in her mom's hands. You seen the baby before you got here?
Yes, yes, yes.
How is she, bro?
She beautiful, beautiful, grown, awesome. When you see her, I mean, it's gonna be such a change.
Arnold told me everything about my little baby. He told me... He told me that my baby is almost twice the size. I was so happy to hear that. You know, it was like my daughter's in her mom's hands. I'm at peace.
Tony. Four votes, Tony. One vote, Wu. The winner of Survivor Cagayan, Tony.